Okay, the objective for today, identify expected competencies among graduates. Whatever technology we use, once again, our main stakeholders in our mind is always our students. A quick scan of learning theories, effective learning, design, multimedia learning. Now, were all discovered at any one time by anybody in the past 2 weeks? Learning theories, behaviorism, cognitivism, constructivism. Anybody touch on this?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. And now just very briefly, it's a quick scan. And then something about multimedia learning. And then we'll touch a bit concerning who we are and open licensing. How many of you are familiar with OER, Open Educational Resources, where those materials are licensed under something called open license? That means they use something called Creative Commons, CC. Anyone using that? Now, it will be Sumo IPTA, all the public universities through the ministry. We are actually working with this. David Warning, he says this: "You must prepare students for a future we can neither describe nor predict." Kita mesti merindakan pelajar untuk masa depan yang kita tidak boleh terangkan atau ramalkan. Now, this is our cabaran lah. How are we going to prepare our students for a future that we ourselves blur? So it's a challenge. This PowerPoint slides are given to you. Now, according to the National Graduate Employability Blueprint, and this one is from our Higher Education Ministry. So it says here that our student attributes, we hope, you know, that they will become very imaginative, innovative, critical, and creative thinkers. In terms of communication, they must know how to integrate technology, they have a teamwork, okay? Commercial awareness, academic performance, good degree classification in terms of content, they are master, and then their attitude, able to adapt. Dear friends, dear colleagues, our job as a lecturer in UMS, okay, is bukan merely to transmit knowledge. It's not our main job. Yes, it is our main job. Our core business. Okay? But more than that, see, you know, it's so much more than that. We're going to make our students not only full of knowledge concerning medical studies and engineering or whatever, but make them critical, creative thinkers. Make them innovative so they can come up with some new creation. Make them critical in the thinking so that when they look at a problem, systematically, they can analyze the problem and come up with a solution. You know what I mean? So, our job as a lecturer, as an educator in UMS, memang full of cabaran. Not merely just transmitting knowledge. This is the 21st century education model. And over here, you can see there's a rainbow, and there are concentric circles over here. Is the mic here? Are you able to hear? Now, the concentric circle, any one of you, anyone have exposed this method to you? No. So, this rainbow actually shows the type of graduates that you want coming out from our university. And, for example, here, life and career skills, in terms of ICT skills, and then in terms of the 4C, that means they are our graduates. Not only master their core content, but also the 4C, able to communicate effectively, able to collaborate as a team player, able to be creative thinkers and critical thinkers. And then whatever that we lead them is all tied up with the core universal subject concerning health problem, concerning environmental problem. So, how can we realize this? Bagaimana direalisasikan dapat graduate dengan competency, competency itu. So these are the enablers. Okay, type of assessment, the type of curriculum, the type of professional development, the learning environment. So my question is, from your experience, young people, from your experience, do you think the system today in the university is able to bring out these people? Or do we need drastic change? So this is a challenge, okay? We know that the system today, there are many, many weaknesses. So young people always challenge the status quo. On one hand, you know, we are young, but because you're young, like our new minister, sports and youth, straight away you say national service abolished. That is drastic. Something big. He dare to, for very good reason. So as long as good reason, hey, be bold. Young people challenge the status quo learners. For the good of the student. For the good of the youth. Oh, there you go. So these are the four C's, okay? So you see, teaching is more than just merely disseminating knowledge. This is our challenge. This is a study done, it's called a longitudinal study. That means it goes through only 1 year, you know, not 3 years, you know, many, many years. Okay? So this one is conducted by Josh Lenz. Okay? You can just Google his name, you can see the study there. Now, what happened is that you follow a group of students, 1,600 students. Try to follow the outcome of this and try to relate it to yourself. Whether it's true here or not. So he measured the divergent thinking among a group of students, 1,600 of them, he followed. When they were in kindergarten, when they were 10 years old, they were 15 years old, okay? And later on, he also looked at over 200,000 people, adults. And he wanted to measure something with divergent thinking. It means the essential capacity for creativity. Now, you can see that I do not know what is in the content of your Bahasa or you know Islamic study or engineering or pharmacy or whatever. Those are your areas of expertise. But I'm saying there's more than that in teaching. For example, how can we inculcate creativity? And these are actually some of the skills that is needed in the 21st century. The test look at a problem and come up with new, different, innovative ideas. So they were given a paperclip, you know, paperclip. And then ask them to play around and see what they can do with the paperclip. And if they can manage to use a paperclip and make up over 10 different things, they are classified as genius. So how many percent do you think kindergarten kids are at a genius level? Make a guess. 60? 70, you have little children. How many percent do we at genius level? Little children. 70, 80, something like that. What do you think? How many percent? 30. You're a man. The ladies know better. Okay. The test showed that actually 98% of the little children are at this level. And then the same group of people, after going through formal education, after going to school, selepas sama sekolah, they do like that. 99? Huh? Jadi, mana boleh go to school? And what do you think? When they go to 11 years to 15 years old, better lah. Better lah. To know what? What do you think? That's what he turun, mana boleh? Okay. Do you think this is true in Malaysia? Yes. The PISA test, the TIM test, and so on, confirm, you know. Last time, more than 10 years ago, this ranking in the world was actually upper quarter. Now we're in the bottom quarter. Something wrong. Our syllabus, our curriculum has been emphasizing to develop critical thinking, creative thinking. But instead, we're going to down, down, down. What is wrong? Student? Because of the system. It means the system is dragging us down. Something wrong. Betul? So that's what I mean, you know, hey, challenge the status quo. If we test the creativity level of a student and it's low, hey, you must question the management. Maybe we address it. Oh yeah, I forgot. So they end up over 250,000 people. And so sorry, except all of us. We've been so conditioned by the system. So when you come out, you say as an adult, you become different. No. You have been actually conditioned by the whole system.
But it is subjective.
Of course, it's very subjective. As I say, exception, like I say.
It depends on how we define it.
Yes, correct. It depends on how we define it. So, okay, these are all open for debates, okay? What happened to our creativity? Who are accountable? Students, teachers, university lecturers, curriculum? Is it the examination? Staff examination? Is it the family? Have there been any one of you that experienced in it when you were young? Somehow you were such an excellent pianist. But you can go on, you can become well renowned, you know, become well renowned maybe. But your mother, your father, don't see a future there. They say, wait, do your mathematics homework rather than your music. Dancing? No. And you're an excellent ballerina. No, no future. Do your science. And the poor, the family members are the ones that fall at home. Have you seen this experience? Can somebody be bold enough within 1 minute to share something? It was supposed to be somebody else, maybe. You start. Within 1 minute. Yeah. Louder, please.
From the beginning, I just follow
what teacher said, what my parents said.
So my teacher actually suggested that I go to boarding school because
I selected. Okay, selected to go to boarding school, teacher said go.
So I
said,
my
friend go because
I'm going to
give up
my head.
Yeah. Follow
on. And that time, that is how yang actually dalam family pun yang tahu. So
you went into a whole new world, and let the whole new world mold you.
Yeah.
Instead of your own inner punya creativity. Okay, good, thank you. Hey, we are questioning now. We are asking, you know, what is wrong? Who is? We are pointing the fingers now. Okay. So is it the excess? Look at this. Have you seen this before? Cikgu ini, after dia punya student lah, all this, and he say for a fair selection, everybody now must take the same exam. And the exam is, hey, all of you, climb the tree. Who do you think will be the winner? Who? Monkey! Naturally. Natural talent, and is that? Who will be the winner? The monkey.
Okay, the bird.
The bird. Mana ada bird?
Memang. The question is to climb the trees, so the monkey will fly.
Hey,
the bird will fly.
How about these people? How about the rest? Is that happening? Okay, is that something that happened to us? You were labeled, you know, after they labeled Odo, labeled Laguna, labeled as no hope. But actually, our talent was there. Someone was not able to actually exploit and assess and bring up that talent to them. Standard assessment, science. But imagine if you feel that, Odo, you know what I mean? So, as educators, dear friends, we need to know that before us, our student, nobody is labeled as good, not able. Everybody has the talent to exploit it. So, Einstein said this: everybody is a genius, but if you judge a fish by his ability to climb a tree, he will live his whole life believing it is stupid. Of course, the animal will his whole life say, I'm stupid, I don't want to climb a tree. I'm no good in music, I cannot play piano, I'm stupid. But people don't measure that, is it? They speak science, mathematics, language. To measure. Is it experience, cool, okay, and what should change? Be critical. Challenge your status quo. In your faculty, be bold. I'm saying this because I'm more elderly than all of you, okay? And you know, our Malaysian culture, our budaya, hey, if you see something, you know, not correct, would you quickly put up your hand and raise it up? No, our budaya is, hey, polite, student, veteran, ada sini. Senior ada sini, professor ada sini. Shh, they know better. You know what I mean? I'm saying no. Challenge you. Please remember that. If you forget about whatever we discussed today, I'm telling you, challenge the status quo always as you go on. And this will keep you fresh. This will be our challenge. All for the sake of the university and the student. So, Charles Darwin said, it's not the strongest of the species that survive, not the most intelligent, but the one most responsive to changes. Change is in the horizon. Tomorrow, a new change will come along. So, we need to embrace it and we need to respond to it. These are some of the changes that are going on. This is the Malaysian Education Blueprint. Have you seen this? Yeah. Okay. You can just Google Malaysian Education Blueprint for Higher Education and you will be able to see this. And we are still using this, you know, under our Pakatan Harapan, masih kita pakai ini. So, what you can see over here is this. There are 10 sheet. Ajakan, 1, 2, 3, 4. The 1, 2, 3, 4 are the type of graduates that we want to produce from our public university, or for that matter, from the university. And all these will be the enablers yang membolehkan, merealisasikan all these. So we want our graduates to be holistic, entrepreneurial, balanced graduates. Lifelong learners, talent, excellence, direct graduates. Many of them here, our concern is this. Number 9, globalized online learning. Very specific item. So this is where Pusat E Pembelajaran in UMS is playing its part. So the Pusat E Pembelajaran, very briefly, started just in October last year. It belong to the town now. Okay, before that it was a unit. Then now we upgrade to Pusat. And memang, semua public university must have a Pusat. But just that we are slower here somehow. Okay? But You know, in the world of technology, we can just leapfrog very fast. The pertimbangan pengarah over there, Dr. Yu Tok Seng, he'll be with us in the second session. We have a coordinator, and we have a coordinator for OER and MOOC, and that is by Dr. Cannon, who happens to be somehow a participant over here. How in the world are you doing here? By the way, these are some of the people, okay? Though we are more elderly than all of you, hey, but these are digital who are crazy about technology and how we can improve teaching and learning. And then we have a plus Salmi, coordinator for blended learning and training. And of course, we have very important people, Zhu Falin, that's Zhu Falin, okay? And there is Fazil, okay? And we also have Azaha, Anita, and we have Elizabeth. So these are the main people actually helping to coordinate activities. And I'm calling all of you young people, hey, you are all the digital kid. So please, you know any activities that we're doing, please come in and support us. And as I say, challenge the status quo. Whatever we do over here, whatever Dr. Kenneth is doing, hey, dare to question it. You know what I mean? Because you people know better. In your area, you know, you could be missing something. Please, come forward. You need to move on together.